Hello student, welcome to Saint Engine online classes. We all are working from home. I hope you all are very well in your home. Student, in previous video we had completed question number 9.20 from NCERT of chapter ray optics. Let's start to solve next question of this chapter, question number 9.21. Student, firstly we solve the first part of this question. Determine the effective focal length of system of combination of two lenses, one of convex focal length 30 cm and other concave of focal length 20 cm. If they are separated by a distance of 8 cm, does the answer depend on which side the combination of parallel beam incident? So according to given data, firstly draw the diagram. A system of lenses consists two lenses, one of convex and other concave, have different focal length. Convex have focal length 30 cm and concave lens has focal length 20 cm and they are separated by a distance of 8 cm. Consider parallel beam incident firstly on convex lens. We have to find the effective focal length of the combination of this lens. Student, equivalent lens or effective lens is that lens which replaced by the combination of lenses. In such way, final position of image remain unaffected for identical object. And generally, effective or equivalent lens is placed between the combination of lenses. Consider this is the effective lens. We know that for effective lens, position of object remain identical as combination of lens. So, U equal to infinite for effective lens also. Now for convex lens, U equal to minus infinite, f equal to plus 30 cm. According to lens formula, 1 upon f equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u, 1 by 30 equal to 1 by v minus 1 by infinite. Hence, v equal to plus 30 cm. It means image of the parallel beam formed by convex lens is at a distance of 30 cm. So draw the ray diagram. So image I dash is clear that image of convex lens I dash act as a virtual object for concave lens, and the distance for virtual object for concave lens is 22 cm. It means for concave lens, U equal to plus 22 cm. F equal to minus 20 cm. According to lens formula, 1 upon F equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. Put the value of f and u. In this equation, we have 1 upon minus 20 equal to 1 by v minus 1 by 22. By solving 1 by 20 plus 1 by 22 equal to 1 by v. Taking LCM, 440 minus 22 plus 20 equal to 1 by V. Minus 2 upon 440 equal to 1 by V. So V equal to minus 220 centimeter. It means image formed by the concave lenses at a distance of 220 centimeter opposite to the direction of rays. So it means this is a diverging lens which diverges the rays. In such way, if we produce backward, so final image form at I, which is at a distance of 220 centimeter from concave lens. So final image of the parallel beam formed by the combination of lenses is at point I. Now if the combination of lens is replaced by single lens L1, which is placed between both lenses, so four equivalent lens L1, U equal to minus infinite and V equal to, since position of final image is at a distance of 220 from concave lens, so that position of final image from equivalent lens is 216 centimeter. So V equal to minus 216 centimeter. According to lens formula, 1 upon F equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. Put the value of V and U. We have 1 by F equal to 1 by 216 minus 1 by infinite. So 1 upon F equal to minus 1 by 216. It means F equal to minus 216 centimeter. It means effective or equivalent lens is concave in nature, and focal length of equivalent lens or effective focal length is 216 centimeter. Now it is clear that if we reverse the direction of parallel beam, that is parallel beam incident on concave lens, since focal length of both lenses are different, so when parallel beam incident firstly on concave lens, then position of image change. As position of image change, so effective focal length also change. Please pause the video and note in your note.